Man, we got Peso Peso. He's a rapper from Galveston, Texas. Now, as a rapper, an individual that doesn't fabricate his entire background or existence, man, we know the law's gonna have their eyes on him. Many rappers are counterfeits, man. They're lying. They're speaking about things they've never done. They're presenting a false image. Then you got a small percentile of artists, rappers, individuals that are making it in that industry who actually have a credible background in regards to the things they're rapping about, all right? The most important aspect is whether or not they're going to evolve, all right? After they get a taste of fame, are they able to exhibit discipline and transfer their methods of revenue, homie, livelihood, so on and so forth, to a more legal avenue? Or are they going to stay slanging, try to come up on all the theoretical profit that's out there, and try to carry themselves with their fame, their celebrity status, their rap career? They usually keep doing both, man. It's an addiction. They can't really transfer from one lane to the other fully, man, and fail-proof themselves. Refuse to provide ammunition that can be utilized against them. That's not what happens. Usually they have one foot still in the field and the other foot in the rap and the fame, and it stays like that, man, because they see that theoretical money out there. They know they used to push weight. They know they used to bring in a lot of revenue. It doesn't matter if they're famous and they're making a lot of money now. It's an addiction, bro. It's theoretical money they can continue to bring in order to exhibit discipline and relinquish or sacrifice that. You know what I mean? Forgo that. They would have to reflect on their health, their freedom. They'd have to value the paramount life aspects. They'd have to basically have a point to their existence or a purpose that revolves around more than just coming up. And that's not what's encouraged in our society, bro. The elite, celebrities, people in power, it doesn't matter if it's rap, Hollywood, everything in our society encourages people to live for their impulses and desires, to live for that money, sex, fame, financial status. It doesn't consist of making people aware of what they possess internally. You feel me? So that's also a contributing factor in regards to these individuals becoming famous, not changing their approach or get down. Peso Peso allegedly failed to do so. Now, he's been arrested by the feds, but I wanted to clarify those aspects first, right? So Peso Peso allegedly was arrested by the feds. He was arrested, but some people say it was for a pistol. Others are saying he was arrested by the feds regarding something more serious than just a pistol charge. But regardless, man, the individual is carrying, he's not supposed to, he's got a felony background, you know what I mean? That's assuming that he's not doing any of the other stuff that he was initially doing in the field before he became famous, right? Let's just say it was only the pistol and not the feds arresting him for multiple criminal offenses and an enterprise of some type, you know what I'm saying, an activity. Let's just say, you know, he wasn't perfect, he had a pistol on him. Those are the kind of things that provide ammunition that can and will be utilized against us. And that's like the best case scenario, bro. Majority of the time, people are still engaged in all the criminal activity and all the BS, bro. It's not just, oh, I changed everything up for I'm exhibiting discipline, but I feel safe with this on me, man. You know what I mean? That's kind of like the best case scenario, bro. You know, unfortunately, bro, the bar is low. I wish more people would evolve, but it's just not common, okay? Now, let's just assume he got caught with that pistol. Bro, that's serious. You got a felony background. You got caught with a firearm. And that's time you're looking at, bro. If you're famous, we know you got legal representation. You know what I'm saying? You got a higher likelihood of beating a case in comparison with your fellow man. But if you're caught doing something red-handed and there's irrefutable evidence against you, you know what I mean? The prosecution rate's high, man. They don't like to lose cases. The prosecutors and stuff, they're going to come after you and you're most likely going to catch time. You know what I'm saying? Eventually you are. Even if you beat that case throughout the time, homie, throughout the road of continuing to carry or provide that ammunition that can be utilized against you, eventually them dice are going to hit snake eyes because you're continuing to roll them. That's what I'm trying to touch down on, bro. A lot of individuals are in a position where they feel like they have nothing to lose. Once they get a taste of fame, man, that's a major opportunity. It doesn't have to revolve around meaningless chaos and damage and all the world-destroying mayhem that we see all these famous individuals living for and exhibiting and perpetuating. You know, majority of individuals, they don't mentally and spiritually evolve. They don't change their perception on life or reality based upon money or fame. It just doesn't happen. But if it did, we could stop them world destroyers in power. We can refuse to provide ammunition that can and will be utilized against us. We can understand that we possess internally what is most important: peace of mind, genuine confidence, purpose, logic, accuracy, homie, efficiency, bro. Having a realistic, accurate perspective on life and reality instead of performing mental gymnastics, homie, and living your mind, bro. Majority are trapped in their mind, regardless how much money or fame they have. They're going to end up making their bed and lying in it, man. And that's completely avoidable. And it's what elitists and major positions of power rely upon. Don't continue to fall into a trap that's already been identified and that is thus completely avoidable. Because if you insist upon remaining in a trap, you cannot dismantle that trap and warn your fellow man about it. It will devour everyone. You don't want evil people in power to get their way and devour everyone and control us like puppets. That's not shining on me. That's not coming up, bro. That's creepy. Let me know what you think of the situation with Peso Peso. I'm not demonizing him, fool. I'm not saying, oh, he's such an idiot. He deserves it. Nah, what I'm saying is a lot of individuals have potential, man. Regardless of whether it's intellect, regardless of whether it's life experience. Okay, people can lead by example and produce results. But if we refuse to exhibit discipline and relinquish that theoretical money or profit that can always be acquired, you know what I mean? That's going to lead to that ammunition being utilized against us, rotting in a cage or dying. You know what I'm saying? You got to forego that theoretical money or profit. You know what I'm saying? Exhibit discipline. Reflect on what you possess internally and continuously progress. Don't do what elitists encourage you to do. I mean, don't dwell within a trap by design, bro. That's goofy.